Welcome to Energy and Light Awakening. We're going to be focusing on grounding, foundation, and feelings of safety and security. It's the perfect as we are now in one season and moving into another, coming out of summer season, moving into fall. What better way to acclimate our energies to the changing season? If you watch my channel regularly, you'll probably recognize this. This is my Wonder Stone. It's one of my favorites to work with. It's extremely grounding. It helps to reduce anxiety, stress, and depression. It's super grounding. It's good for mental clarity and insight, overall sense of well-being. It's also great for your life force energy. I'm just going to play the bottom of your feet. We're also using the powerful energies of this larvacite, which is also excellent for grounding, for positivity and peace. It helps cleanse the emotions. It's great for psychic protection. It's also excellent for balancing out your energies. And three more powerhouse stones for grounding and protection are black tourmaline, black kyanite, and Apache tear. These are also great for detoxification, helping with stress, to help with a positive attitude. They can be great as protectors. They're also good to use for emotional support. We're also going to be working with a few Grandmaster symbols today. The first one is Dai Cho Wa, and this is for harmony and balance. Wa, this is for peace. And this one is Dai Tetsu, and this is for wisdom. And so today we're going to do a little bit of meditation as I do the Reiki. So please make yourself comfortable. I want you to begin, envision or imagine with your eyes open or closed. You may even want to hold your hands out to the sides with your palm down. And I want you to begin to visualize energy cords coming from your body, going down into Mother Earth. See these little cords coming out of your fingertips, out of your palms. Feel the energy in the body moving down to your feet, and also bringing energy cords out of your feet. It could be one large cord from each foot, or it could be little cords attached to each toe. And just feel those cords tethering into the earth, moving down into the deepest, darkest places of the earth, the most ancient and sacred areas that our ancestors used to connect with and celebrate. Feel that divine connection to Mother Earth. Feeling that connection and that energy moving up your tethered cords, pulling up into your body, up into the legs, the top of the legs, into your hips, moving all the way up to the stomach and the center of the body, up to the chest, the neck, and the top of the head, feeling this movement front to back and side to side, and just taking a moment to really appreciate and to be grateful, thanking Mother Earth for this connection. So many of us have lost our way. We no longer celebrate or connect with the earth the way our ancestors did. We're not as grateful and connected. And we cannot live without the earth. Our mother supports our life. She gives us water to drink, food to eat, air to breathe. Just taking a moment to feel that connection and give gratitude. How often do we actually give gratitude to the earth? Something I like to do when I go outside is I just place my hand on my heart and I say out loud or think, "Thank you, Mother Earth, for this beautiful day and all that you do." And if you do this, you might be surprised at what happens afterwards. Anytime I do this, immediately it is followed by a soft breeze and a rattling of the trees. She will respond to you if you're open and receptive. Everything is alive and a part of us, and we are a part of it. It is always responding and just feeling that deep rooted connection, how stable and balanced you feel. And occasionally something else I like to do, besides verbally giving gratitude, I will create an offering, a beautiful plate of fruit, and I will take it outside and place it under a tree and just leave it as an offering. And you can do anything, it doesn't have to be fruit. And just giving that gratitude and acknowledging what we are receiving and giving back, because we are always taking. But this is more of a perfect balance of give and take. It was in the beginning. It's a beautiful energy exchange that helps balance everything out. Feeling that energy and the connection of our ancestors. Remember who you are, remembering that deep connection. Noticing how you feel right now, your whole body is vibrating and tingling. Feel how good and amazing you feel. And you can go outside, place your hands on the earth, on the trees, put your feet in the earth, just absorbing all of that good energy into you. What a precious gift of healing. Begin to pull those cords, the energy cords, back into your body. Feel them coming back up into your feet, into your hands. You're going to feel so much better now. You're going to feel lighter and grounded, stable and connected. All this beautiful energy with the Udrika protection symbol. And we're going to use a little sage water just to boost and brighten that aura. Notice how fresher you're feeling. It smells so good, so earthy, so calming and healing. Thank you so much for joining me today, everyone. It is an honor, a privilege, and I'm very grateful to share this experience with you today. Thank you so much for your continued love and support. I truly and deeply appreciate you so very much. And until my next video, there's much love for you here. Highest blessings and infinite gratitude. Sat Nam.